G'day everybody. In preparation for my video reaction today to Angelina Jordan singing I'm Not The Only One, the Sam Smith song, I was thinking we often like to compartmentalise musicians or artists into a particular box in terms of the style of music they perform. Sometimes this is actually useful for us in gaining an understanding of, you know, the type of music they usually perform, or to get an idea of whether you will go ahead and listen or not. I get asked this question quite a lot as a musician. What type of music do you write? What type of music do you play? What type of music do you sing? And usually my reaction is a variety. Well, I'm a jazz keyboard player, but I play a lot of pop music. I write original songs that could be classed as adult contemporary or a bit more rocky. I also perform rock. So it's such a variety. And it's hard to say, well, I do this. Some artists, yes, they perform a style. They might be a jazz singer or a jazz drummer or a rock guitarist. But others just branch out into such a variety that it's hard to classify them. Angelina Jordan is like this. And she has demonstrated her ability to perform pop music, such as this song, her own original music, which, I mean, how do you classify an original song? Is it pop style? Maybe a little. She performs EDM, electronic dance music, extremely well, and her jazz repertoire is extensive as well. So, you know, again, she comes at music from a variety of perspectives. Music is music. So sometimes we can just describe music as music. Other times, as I said, it is useful and it can be helpful to describe a type of music that a performer delivers or a type of song they usually do. So anyway, that's just an interesting mindset I wanted to just discuss to start with. But anyway, Angelina is broad and diverse and she's great at everything she does. Something I wanted to come to is her story that she wrote. Now, this doesn't really have anything to do with the video, but it does have to do with Angelina's diverse background. And I know many of my viewers will know about Angelina's story she has written and why she performs barefoot. But there'll be many people out there that may not know this. So anyway, a number of years ago, when Angelina was a lot younger, she wrote a story, and this was illustrated by her grandmother, Mary Zamani, who's a talented artist of Iranian background. So a little bit about the story. So yes, in 2015, Angelina's book was published, and I'll try and pronounce the Norwegian correctly. Just find where I've written my adaptation of it. So I would say Melom Tuyate. Melom Tuyate. And this translates into English, Between Two Hearts. So this was a story after Angelina met a disadvantaged girl that had made a huge impact on her. And because this girl had no shoes, this sparked an idea for Angelina to write a story which was about a shoeless girl she met in the streets in the Middle East. And the girl was living a completely different life to hers. And some of the lines are, we look into each other's eyes, she peers at me. I have to manage this, I have to do something, she must not freeze. She has beautiful blue eyes, her eyes are the colour of sky and sea. She does not want to talk to anyone, but even though she might not want to talk to me, I really want to try. Wow. And after they spoke, she gave the girl green shoes and vowed never to appear on stage again wearing shoes. So since then, she performs barefoot with her songs. Beautiful. Beautiful, isn't it? And heartwarming. But anyway, I just wanted to talk about that. And that story is available if anyone wishes to purchase it. And I'm sure you'll find the links on the internet. If you Google it, you'll find exactly where you can purchase Angelina's story from. So anyway, the song, I'm Not the Only One. This is a song released in 2014 by Sam Smith via digital download. And this was written by Sam Smith and Jimmy Napes. And Jimmy Napes also co-produced the song. And it's a mid-tempo, soulful piano ballad. And it's based on a true story about someone that Sam Smith and Jimmy Napes knew. So this is a recording Angelina made, I believe it was approximately 1 to 2 years ago. And the video clip depicts her on a family vacation. So anyway, let's hear it.
For better or for worse, I can't believe you let me down. But the proof in the way it hurts. For months on end, I have my doubts. Denying every tear. I wish this would be over now, but I know that I still need you here. You say I'm crazy, 'cause you don't think I know what you've done. But when you call me baby, I know I'm not the only one. You've been so unavailable. Now sadly I know why. Your heart is unobtainable, even though you don't share mine. You say I'm crazy, 'cause you don't.
Magical performance. and magnificently performed by Angelina, as always. Ah, what a lovely interpretation of that song. She actually made it her own version. She, as she always does, she always delivers a song and it's in her own style. She's been respectful of the ballad nature of the song, and in that respect, it's just as Sam Smith performed, but she's put her own take on it and added her own touches and nuances, which I'll highlight many of these in a moment. And it's just so beautiful. I'm not sure who the guitarist is. Is it Ivan Mendez? Hopefully I pronounced his name correctly there, Ivan. I'm not sure if it is. Maybe someone knows and will be able to let me know in the comments. Just out of interest. Beautiful guitar work. Beautiful. Oh. Angelina has such a soulful, reflective style to her vocals that are just beautiful. And let's hear some of the things I would like to highlight. Rather than going straight into something like vibrato or high notes, I'm going to go straight to a phrase that I just loved. I loved everything she did, but this phrase in particular, I just liked it without any reason, without any musical background or without any description or analysis. Just have a listen.
I'm crazy.
Ooh, that was it. The I'm crazy line.
Yes, I. Cause you don't think I know what you've done.
And the response, it's a bit like a call and response phrase. And, you know, probably I could analyse it and say why I like it, but I just loved it because I loved it. I'll play it again.
You say I'm crazy. Cause you don't think I know what you've done.
I think it's because of the vocal fry in the first phrase, but it's not just that. It's the tonal quality, timbre that she has in her voice that is so beautiful. And the way she used the response phrase, like call and response, like a question and an answer, and you don't know the something I've done. I can't remember the exact words. I'm useless with words in remembering them like that. But that response phrase, she just responds, it's like, here's the question, and there's an answer, and there's like resolution to it. I just loved it, and just wanted to point that out. Beautiful. Let's go to some of her ornamentation. I absolutely loved the way she did quite a lot of ornaments through this on certain syllables of notes. And let's, we'll hone in, and I'll be a little more specific.
Denying every tear.
On the word, the syllable vri, I can't remember the word, something every, vri, something like that. Love that little ornament. It's like a mordent, we would call that.
And I have my doubts, denying every tear. I wish this would be over now, but...
And that was more of a little riff there, but you would... A riff is an ornamentation. It was a small riff, small ornament that was just so beautiful in that descending phrase that she just ended on where I stopped it. I'll play all of it again from about this point.
Denying every tear. I wish this would be over now, but I know.
Lovely. And let's go to another one at this point.
But when you call me baby, I know I'm not the only one.
Lee. Only one. On Lee of Only. You can hear it, but there were those few that I pointed out as it went through. Let's hear it again, though. There were about four or five, and they were just so beautifully done.
But when you call me baby, I know
can't. And now there's more coming up. I'll just skip it forward to here. More ornamentation.
Maybe I'm not just enough.
Well, that was more of a big long riff, which is an ornament, like I said. But just before that, I know I'm just enough. I can't remember the words. Should have them in front of me, shouldn't I?
Maybe I'm not just enough.
Oh, that was beautiful. Okay, let me find exactly where these lyrics are up to. Then I can say the right words. I can hear the musical notes in Angelina's voice, but just the words. I can obviously understand every single thing she's singing, but it's just my memory for words is usually like this, and I hear the music and the words, what are they? I'd have to hear it and then say straight away.
Realize my deepest fear by lying in tears. You said
that time it was the end of that phrase, but also on the word fear. The little ornaments that she put in there decorated it so beautifully.
You made me realize my deepest fear.
Now I can stop it. And on the word tearing us up, that ornamentation there is just so nice. I'll play it again.
Realize my deepest fear.
And on
fear.
Sorry, I'm going to play it again. Yes, on the word fear as well. Beautiful little ornament.
You made me realize my deepest fear by lying and tears. You said.
Yes, absolutely lovely. Okay, let's now go and have a listen. She has a little bit of vocal fry for effect that just adds to the flavour of the song and helps that emotional character come through. She's projecting the meaning behind the lyrics of the song, and this adds to the emotion of that projecting of lyrics. Projecting the sentiment of the song so beautifully.
'Cause you don't think I know what you've done. But when you call me baby,
and did you hear that next phrase, when you call me baby? She sings without any of the crackle. She's deliberately calculated where it's going to have the most effect, and that's where she's used it on the previous phrase. So I'll play that again.
I'm crazy. 'Cause you don't think I know what you've done. But when you call me baby, I know I'm not the only.
Yeah, beautiful, right? And then she used a breath for effect at this point.
But when you call me baby, I know I'm.
Love the way she sang the word one as well. Oh, it was a lovely, lovely end to that phrase. Let's hear all of that again though. So the two breaths in was so effective.
What you've done, but when you call me baby, I know I'm not the only one.
Yes. Okay, let's have a listen to. Oh, I have a little bit more of her vocal fry. I didn't highlight that a moment ago. I only went to one of my examples, but I really loved the other ones, the other times she used it too, and I'd really like to come to this.
You've been so one of available.
Oops, that was the wrong place. From here.
I have loved you for many years. Maybe I'm not just enough.
Oh, that riff. Gorgeous. Let's hear some of the vocal.
I have loved you for many years. Maybe I'm not just enough.
Yes. Touch of vibrato at the end too. We'll come to vibrato in a minute. Let's hear another example of her beautiful vocal.
When you call me baby, I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one.
Yes, let me play that again. Quite a few examples of vocal fry in that particular section of the song. Then with that beautiful riff down.
You call me baby, I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one. I know I'm not the only one.
Oh, so nice. Now, have a listen to the way she sings the word I here and keeps it quite wide. I really love the way she sings everything and then suddenly has this really wide vowel. It works so well.
You've been so unavailable. Now sadly I know why.
Actually, it was probably more on the word Y. That's why I've written the letter I, but it's a W-H-Y, obviously, but it's an I sound. But on the word, on the actual word I, just before that, she sung that a little bit wide and then Y was a lot wider. I loved it.
Oh, now sadly I know why.
Mm. I'll play it again.
Now sadly I know why.
Yes, I loved it. Let's hear some of that beautiful vibrato. We've heard a lot already in those examples, but let's highlight it now.
For better or for worse,
yeah.
I can't believe you let me down, but the proof in the way it hurts.
And just the way that last touch of vibrato faded out on the word hurts. I loved it. Let's, yes, go back from the same place. We'll hear that again.
For better or for worse, I can't believe you let me down, but the proof in the way it hurts.
Oh, beautiful. And just in that phrase, something that I hadn't made note of was the way she sung the word down, down. She kept that quite wide as well. And I just loved the way she vocalized that word. It was just beautiful. I mean, you could go through so many more things, but I do want to go back just to catch that again. It was beautiful.
But the proof in the way it hurts. For months on end, I have my doubts.
Maybe I didn't go back far enough. I'll go back again and try and catch the word down.
Better or for worse, I can't believe you let me down, but the proof in the way it hurts.
Yes, that was excellent. Let's return to her vibrato.
My doubts, denying every tear, I I wish this would be over now, but I know that I still need you here.
Oh, so many great examples of her vibrato there. I'll go over that one more time.
Denying every tear, I wish this would be over now, but I know that I still need you here.
Oh, so well controlled. Now let's have a listen to some of her higher end. She gets this beautiful, beautiful tone, and oh, it's right here.
You say I'm crazy, 'cause you don't think I know what you've done. But when you call me baby, I know I'm not the only one.
Yes, let's hear it all again.
I still need you here. You don't think I know what you've done, but when you call me baby, I know I'm not the only one.
Yes, let's hear another example of her beautiful high end.
You don't share my...
Well, it's low there.
You say...
Brilliant. Now let's go to some of her rich low end. We just heard a tiny bit then at the start of that segment, but let's go to here.
You've been so unavailable. Now sadly I know why. Your heart is unobtainable, even though you don't share mine.
Beautiful, right? So rich and resonating. I'll play it again.
You've been so unavailable. Now sadly I know why. Your heart is unobtainable, even though you don't share mine.
Excellent. Oh, she gets such a beautiful, rich low end. That deep, beautiful, resonating tone. I absolutely love. Well, that concludes my reaction today. I'm hoping the video is not going to go all jumpy. I don't think it will this time. I can't see how long I've gone for, but I think it's over 20 minutes, but it still should be okay. I'm crossing my fingers. I hope you enjoyed the reaction today. Apologies for me not remembering vocal as in lyrics of the song, but anyway, I hope you enjoyed it all the same, and I look forward to seeing you very soon again on another reaction. Bye for now.